Welcome, welcome one and all to another online broadcast of our service. We would like to welcome you. Thank you so much for choosing to join us at Greater Works International Ministries. And for all of you who are joining us in-house as well, thank you again for visiting with us and joining us in this time of praise and worship in celebration of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So we would like to stand to our feet this morning as we officially begin the service. Are you guys happy to be here today? Are you happy to be viewing with us? Let's see those fire emojis in the comment section if you are happy and excited to be here. Those of you who are in-house, come on, just put your hands together for the Lord this morning. Are you glad to be here? Come on, let me get a happy clap here this morning. He said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. And so we are happy to be in the house. So are you happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Can I get a hallelujah, somebody? Can I get a praise the Lord? Can I get a something? Can I get a praise this morning that lets the devil know that I made it in the house of the Lord? You may have tried what you wanted to try, but I made it through the door. Can I get a witness this morning? I felt that in my spirit right there. I said I made it through the door. The fact that you are here, it means that the enemy is already defeated. I didn't get enough praise here this morning. I said the fact that you made it through the door, the devil is already defeated. Somebody shout hallelujah. Oh, I wish I had some praise up here this morning. I don't know how you got up this morning, but you can command yourself to give God glory. Father, we give you the praise. We lift you up this morning, for you are worthy of the praise. You are worthy of the glory. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be magnified. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy of our praise. You are worthy of our worship. You are worthy of our offering. You are worthy of our thanksgiving. For you are Lord, you are God, you are King, you are Master, you are Savior, you are Redeemer, you are Healer, you are Deliverer, you are Counselor, you are Waymaker. Oh, I ain't got no help here this morning. Somebody bless his name. Somebody magnify the Lord. Somebody magnify the Lord, for he is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be lifted up. Come on, somebody, exalt him with us. We bless you this morning. We glorify you this morning. We honor you this morning. We lift you up this morning. Come on, the Bible says in Psalms 34 and verse 1, it says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul, I said, my soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt the name together. Come on, somebody, and bless him. Father, we bless you for all that you've done and for all that you're about to do. We've come with expectation, knowing that you are God, knowing that you are King, knowing that you are Master, knowing that you are able to do abundantly, exceedingly, far above all that we can ask, think, or imagine. Somebody give God a shout of praise.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, bless the Lord this morning. Put a praise on your breakthrough this morning. Put a praise on your healing this morning. Our praise is a weapon this morning. Hallelujah. For we serve a God that is able. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever think or imagine. Bless the Lord. For we know that our God is not just big. He's not just large. But he's a great God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You are God, you are not just big, you are not just large, you are a great God, say you are God.
You are God,
you are not just big,
you are not just big,
you are not just large,
you are not just large,
you are a great God,
you are a great God.
You are a great God.
You are a great God. You are big, big, big. You are big, 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 big.
Large, large,
large, large, large, large, large, large, large, large.
Great,
great, great, great, great, great. You are a great God. You are not just big,
you are not just large,
you are a great God.
You are a mighty God.
You are a great God.
You are a healing God.
You are a great God.
You are an awesome God.
You are a great God.
You are a righteous God. Yes,
you are a great God.
You are a providing God.
You are a great God.
Shelter, you are our strength.
Your voice and say, you deserve
the glory
and the honor
and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands and worship.
Somebody lift up their hands right there and sing.
As we bless your holy
name. Come on, give him a
wave.
No one else like you.
so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you.
For you are great. For
you are great. You do miracles so great.
Somebody let that worship come out from your spirit. Sayonara,
worship you. Somebody ought to worship him. I feel the anointing. Somebody worship him. Show up for you even in your family. I'll show up in your finances, my God. And I'll show up even in this place. Somebody lift up your hands. Because there's about to be a divine visitation in this place. And I want you to forget about who's next to you. This is, forget about how the service is supposed to go, how it's supposed to sound. And just worship God. He says, if I did it before, I can do it again. I'll do it again. I'll do it again. Don't you know I can do it again? I can do it again. Because what is this mountain that stands before you? What is this valley that you cannot cross? What is this mountain that stands before you? What is the trial, says the Lord? Don't you know that there's nothing that's too hard? There's nothing that's too big. There's nothing that's too wide. There's nothing I cannot do. There's nothing I cannot do. There's no sickness I cannot heal. There's no battle I cannot fight. There's nothing I cannot deliver you out of. The Lord says, if I did it before, I'd do it again. I'll do it again. I'll do it again. I don't know who this word is for this morning. But the Lord says, I'll do it again. And I put your enemies to shame. The Lord says, I'll do it again.
This morning.
Anybody want this place to be filled with the glory of the Lord?
Come
on and lift up your hands and worship Him.
Oh,
wish I had some people who knew how to dig deep this morning. For the Lord is here this morning in the midst of his people. And I see a cloud of glory. I see a cloud of glory over this house. But I see as if the cloud of glory wants to expand and fill up the room. But it's dependent on your hunger. It's dependent on your hunger. The Bible says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst. Are there any hungry people in this house? Are there any hungry people in this house? Where is your appetite for the presence? Where is your appetite for the glory? Where is your appetite for his power? Are you hungry this morning? Are you hungry for an encounter? It's an encounter. Somebody needs to encounter him. Somebody worship. Somebody who's hungry. Somebody's screaming in this place. This is the month of the encounter. Somebody worship him. Don't you leave your heads down this morning. Those hands and worship. Holy, Come on. lift up your hands all over this place. Today will be a day of encounter with Him.
I could feel your mighty power.
I don't know about you, but I'm experiencing my encounter.
Moving in this place, we're in the presence of angels.
With God's glory
on their wings, like the voice of many waters. I can hear the angels sing. Holy.
Somebody lift your hands and tell it. Already here. If you don't know that there are angels in this place, I see them moving to and fro. I see them moving to and fro. Somebody gonna lift up your hands. I said, this is, if you didn't have expectation, now is the time. Lift up your hands. He's about to do a new thing in this place. If you're not bowing, if there's not anything wrong with you, stand to your feet in reverence of the Lord and worship Him. Lift up your hands. Let's not grieve His Spirit this morning. I don't care who you are. Stand to your feet and lift up your hands. If you're bowing, that's okay. If you're lying down prostrate, that's okay. If something is wrong, that's fine. But if all is well with you, you ought to stand to your feet and worship Him. He deserves at least that. He deserves at least that. That's why we're here. Come on and worship Him. Come on and worship Him. Don't you know that He's in this place? Don't you know that He is here? Come on and worship Him. I know you want it from another song, but it's not time. Come on and worship him. It is your, don't miss your moment of encounter. Don't miss your encounter this morning. Don't miss your encounter this morning. Somebody worship him. Come on and go a little deeper this morning. Somebody's about to give birth to something. Somebody's about to be a carrier of the glory. Lift up those hands. I will exalt you. I will exalt you. You are my God. Come on, join with me and sing. I will exalt you. Your hands lifted up, sing, I will exalt you.
I will exalt you.
I will exalt you, Lord.
I will exalt you.
You are my God. You are my God.
You are.
a little bit and sing.
I will exalt you, Lord.
I will exalt you. Ooh,
my God. I'll exalt you,
Jesus.
This morning.
I will not fear, no.
Most holy, Just lift your head to heaven. Just for a minute, just worship Him just for a minute. Just lift your head and just make your own melody. Just your own melody. The way you worship at home. The way you express yourself in His presence. Just lift your hand and just worship Him. Just lift your hand and worship. Worship the King this morning. Worship the Lord this morning. He is mighty. He is God all by Himself. All by Himself, He is God. And so you can just worship Him. You can just worship Him. What an awesome God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. It says angels bow before Him, and heaven and earth adores Him. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. What a mighty God we serve. What an excellent God we serve. My God, His splendor is seen throughout. His excellency is seen throughout. His perfection is seen throughout. The scripture says, by His word, the worlds were framed. Scripture teaches us this morning, my God, that the world was structured, the world was framed by His spoken word, and so your life is indeed a spoken word, and so you cannot die in your battle, you cannot walk away in your battle. You cannot give up in your battle. You cannot falter in your battle. My God, you are a spoken word. My God, you've had an encounter with the King this morning. You are a word released, your word declared. You are a word established this morning. Somebody lift your hand to heaven, because you are a spoken word. That's why you didn't die. That's why the accidents did not kill you. That's why you did not lose your mind, because you are a spoken word. My God, you are a revealed word. You are a manifested word. You can lift your hand this morning, my God, because you have an encounter with Him. Somebody just clap your hand and just declare that I am a spoken word. Just clap your hand, because you are a spoken word this morning. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the living God. Praise the name of our Lord and our King. Hallelujah. Isn't God an awesome God? Come on, I can hear you. Isn't God an awesome God? Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I know we want to do the welcome and all of that, but I want to give my brother a chance just to come and testify before we go into the welcome and do all of these things. Amen. Praise God. You know, I believe that testimonies are necessary. Testimonies are important. The scripture says we overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Praise God. I believe that every one of you here should have a testimony. But imagine when we declared something, when God spoke something, you know, how many of you remember we spoke about having keys in your hand just about 2 Sundays ago? Praise God. Well, I can tell you definitely that this word has been made manifest. Can you, don't go yet, can I get the mic? Let's get a cordless mic. Thank you, sir. Praise God. We're just going to have this testimony. Come, my brother, come. Praise God. He came excited this morning to testify of what God has done for him. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, church. I'm Marlon. I'm Ben. They call me Ben. Yeah. This testimony about the blessings of God, what he did for me. It's been 11 months since in July. My brother, they killed my brother. I had to bury my brother. After the burial of my brother, we went home. When my wife opened the house, she feel a strange feeling. All herself start itching. She start complaining a whole month itching. So in the following month, the same symptoms are happening to me. I could not sleep. I don't know what to do. I keep on spending useless money. I go to the Owen King Hospital. They do different tests for me, all different kind of tests. The doctor tell me, son, somebody is working something on you. Because they give me heart, because my heart pumping, keep on pumping, my feeling my head bursting. Heart tests, blood tests, all different kind of tests, scan tests, nothing. The doctor tell me somebody's working on you, son. So I decided to come to the house of the Lord, which is Greater Works. Greater Works. Thank you, Greater Works. I started inviting myself to the service. I started talking to the pastor. I told him my situation. He told me, don't worry about what they say about you. God will bless you. So it's a long story, but I just want to bring it short. So 2 Sundays back, pastor was talking about keys. You understand? So that was the Monday. The Sunday was a service. Monday, when I reached to the roundabout VG, I get a phone call. It was Brother Albert. He called me. Tell me, Ben, I want you to do some work for me up the mall opposite OECS, the old archive building. I tell him, yes. Tuesday, I will come. Tuesday next week, I will come. Whilst I was working for him, he told me, Ben, come. I have something for you. told me he has that vehicle selling. But he's selling it for me for that price, $25,000. A BMW X5. That roof, that building roof, $60,000 to $70,000. And he told me he have other tools he want to give me. Because so long he know me, and you know, he live in the island, because they came to St. Lucia and live, but they had children in England. They had to go back to England and stay, so they sell all the assets and everything. But he tell me, Ben, this vehicle is yours. I tell Brother Albert, you sure? So I went inside, so I tell one of my workers, drugs. You know the boss say, selling me that vehicle for $25,000. You think that man good in his head? So drugs tell me, Ben, that's a blessing God sent for you. That's a blessing God sent for you, Ben. It's a blessing. Take that vehicle. So I going up and down, I thinking, that's a blessing. So I start praying. I start saying, the Lord is my shepherd. You understand? I start calling on the Lord. He tell me that's a blessing. So when they see you falling, that vehicle should show you rising, Ben. Take that vehicle. So I call the credit union. I tell them I want a loan. They tell me, Ben, in the next 2 days, come for the check. 2 days. So, who Jah bless, no man curse. Opportunities come in my way. Work, I keep on working. And my children always tell me, Daddy, let's go to church. But I wasn't listening to them. I keep on working, because God gave me the blessing. Every day I was working, but God was calling upon me. And today, thank you, Greater Works. Thank you.
Amen, amen, and amen. Praise God. When we have testimonies like that, we can't let it go. He said, the children came and say, Apostle, my daddy said, you have to testify. He's ready. You know, because God, and the one thing we know about God is when God speak a word, that we have to step out in faith on that word. Amen. Praise God. There are many other scenarios where God have opened up doors, you know. But again, we're going to take some of these testimonies. We want to at least be able to take a testimony or two each week. Amen. Praise God. So at this present time, we just moving forward. Praise God. I'm going to call Prophetess Sandra just to greet you. Praise God. Those of you online and in-house, we just want to extend greetings to you.
Hallelujah. What an awesome God we serve. Hallelujah. Powerful testimony. Hallelujah. This is a season of great things. This is a season God is shifting. This is a season that He's doing awesome work in our life. This morning, I want to thank you for viewing. Those of you viewing online, I want to thank you. I want to give you a great welcome from Greater Works Ministries this morning. I want to thank those who've been here for the first time. Is there anyone here for the first time? Praise the name of Jesus. You are most welcome. Amen. I pray that God is going to bless you. Hallelujah. You are blessed in the house today. I thank God for the new thing that He has been doing with Greater Works Ministry. You are welcome again. I say welcome and stay blessed. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. At this present time, we're just going to quickly take up the offering, the tithes, the offering. We do have a special dance for you this morning. Praise God. But before we take that, we're going to just take up the offering and our tithes. Praise God.
Beautiful.
God. Come on, just stand to your feet. I believe that this is an atmosphere that is right.
To give. We declare, God, it's going to be pressed down, shaken together and running over. There will be no need that will be unmet. There will be nothing, oh God, in their life that you will not be able to provide as a result of their giving. Let their giving open doors and avenues and opportunities in the name of Jesus. And those who did not have to give, Father, I declare and decree that you will give unto them. Your word declares that you are the one that gives the seed to the sower. And so, Father, you will provide for them that the next time that they enter into the house of the Lord, that they will be able to give, and they will give joyfully, and they will give bountifully. In the name of Jesus, somebody say amen.
The name of the Lord. At this present time, we do have a dance by Sister Leah Gilbert. Come on, just put your hand together for her as she comes to minister to you in dance. Amen. Thank you, worshipers.
Pushing past the fear, fighting to believe, he is making ways for me. And he won't let me down, never ever leave, he's still making ways for me. When my heart is full of doubt, it feels like faith is running. God.
working right now. He's 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 working right now. I know it, I know it. He's working right now. I believe his word. God is working now. God is working now. One thing I know, one thing I found. Oh, God is working.
Come on, just sing it one more time. Sing it out.
Hallelujah. God is working it out. Praise God. This is really the month of encounter. Amen. And today, our topic for today is divine encounter. Amen. Some of you are going to have indeed a divine encounter with God. Hallelujah. So today, I'm going to just simply call on Prophetess Marilyn Hippolyte. Praise God. Come put your hand together for the woman of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. We do have Sunday school, so you can have the kids go to the back. Amen.
Hallelujah. How many of you believe that God is working it out this morning? I don't care what the devil say. But all I know is that my God is working it out. And he's working it out for my good. He's working it out for your good. In spite of what you see or what you have already heard, God is working it out. I mean, when you come into an atmosphere like this, you want to just continue to flow because you know that your God is doing something extra special this morning. Bless the name of the Lord. And this morning, let me just run because I'm not just the only one. Glory be to God. But as everybody know, we have been dealing with the month of encounters, and I don't know about you, but I am excited because every time you look around or you listen to the news, or all what you see or you hear is the negativity. But when you understand in the month of encounters, you are coming to a place to be sensitive that God is getting ready to just come on, crash your party. He is coming right where you are in spite of what you have heard, what you have seen, or even what you have gone through. You see, and this is much needed in this season because the people of God has gone through much. And all we have heard is our flaws, our faults, our mistakes, and our failures. But it is assuring to know that there is a God that has set himself up to have an encounter with you. Because your heart believes in him. Because your cries and your prayers have been common before him. And so therefore, he is coming to show himself strong on your behalf. And though we are speaking of divine encounters today, I want to look at two encounters very quickly this morning. Because we have the godly encounter. We have the encounter where God steps in. But we also have an encounter where the devil steps in. We have the encounter where you go before God because of your situation. And we have some encounters where men will go before the soothsayers to have an encounter with familiar spirits. My God. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 28, I want to pick up the reading there because we are going to look at this morning, hallelujah. We are going to look at King Saul this morning. We are going to take a look at the life of this man named Saul. Because this is a man, according to the scripture, that the people had chosen and asked to be king. And we see an instruction be given to him by the prophet Samuel. Just laying a small foundation here. And we see his disobedience to that which the Lord had asked him to do. And I said to you today that when you walk in disobedience or you open the door for disobedience in your life, you are going to have some unpleasant encounters. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to just pick up the reading from verse 4. No, let me back it up a little bit. Hallelujah to Jesus. Let me take it from verse 3. Now Samuel was dead, and all Israel had lamented him and buried him in Ramah, even in his own city. And Saul had put away those that had familiar spirits and the wizards out of the land. And the Philistines gathered themselves together and came and pitched in Shunem. And Saul gathered all Israel together and they pitched it in Gilboa. And when Saul saw the host of the Philistines, he was afraid and his heart greatly trembled. And when Saul inquired of the Lord answered him not. Somebody pay attention here today. Neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets. Then said Saul unto his servants, seek me a woman that have a familiar spirit, that I may go to her and inquire of her. And his servant said to him, behold, there is a woman that have a familiar spirit at Endor. Now understand what the reading say. By his word, by his command, by his order, all wizards, all familiar, those who dealt with familiar spirits had to be dealt with. But he came to a place in his life, a place of desperation, a place where his back was against the wall, because the scripture says that the Philistines, the enemy, had guarded against him. And when he went to inquire, God did not speak to him. There was no sign coming. Not even the prophets answered him. This, I say, is a dilemma. And because of that, we see a retrogression here. We see the very thing, my God, the very thing that he had asked to get rid of is the very thing he now is inquiring of. And I want to say that to us here today. When we come to a place where we do not honor God for who he is, nor hold on to his word, or walk in the spirit of disobedience, there will come a time when the voice of God will be silent on your behalf. Listen to me. Because God likens disobedience as the sin of witchcraft. So for those of us who feel it's my life and I can do just what I want to do, go ahead, but understand when the enemy will come up against you, when they will besiege you in a corner, you will then turn around to call upon that same God, because at this point you will want to have an encounter with him because you need some answers or you want a way out of it. And this is what happened to Saul at that time. But there was no answer coming. And when you, who the Lord has taken out of Egypt, out of the world, he has taken you out of situations, even abusive situations, He has taken you out of a place even of brokenness, my God. And when you will have forgotten that it was the Lord, and will choose now to do what you want to do, how you want to do it, with the body that you have, understand today that God is not obligated to answer you. Somebody let us, we say he's a good God and a great God. Oh yes, he is. But your lifestyle, to every action, there is a reaction. And sometimes we do not look ahead, or when the enemy makes us feel that we have our own keys, we make our own monies, and so therefore we can do what we want to do and how we want to do it, defy that which God have asked us not to do. He failed to cause us to understand that the time will come when the trap he has set for us, when we fall into that trap, we will turn around and call upon the name of God. But God is a God of order, a God of structure. My God, listen to me. And God will not come down to where you are. You ought to go up to where he is. Hallelujah. And so when Saul saw the Philistines, he was afraid, because he knew he was trapped. He knew this was a situation that he could not have gotten himself out of. We're talking about encounters here today. Thank you, Jesus. And he asked his servants to seek a woman that had the very thing, my God, that he had asked to be abolished in the country. And what did he do in verse 8? And Saul disguised himself and put on another raiment, another outfit, another dressing. And he went, and two men with him. And they came to the woman by night. And he said, I pray thee, divine unto me by the familiar spirit, and bring me him up whom I shall name unto you. And the woman said unto him, behold, thou knowest that Saul, because she did not know who was before her, have done how he have cut off those that have familiar spirits and the wizards out of the land. Wherefore then layest thou a snare for my life to cause me to die? And Saul swore to her by the Lord, saying, as the Lord, look at where he's going to swear. He is going to do something he knows that is out of context and character. But he is going to swear to her by the Lord, saying, as the Lord liveth, there shall no punishment happen to thee for this thing. I want to run a little bit. And then the woman asked him, whom shall I bring? And he said, bring up Samuel. And when the woman saw Samuel, she cried with a loud voice. And the woman spake to Saul, saying, why hast thou deceived me, for thou art Saul? And the king said unto her, be not afraid, for what sawest thou? Because this is the information he wanted. And the woman said unto Saul, I saw gods ascending out of the earth. Somebody hear me here today. We're talking about encounters. Obviously, this was a powerful witch. This was a witch that had the ability to navigate into spiritual realms and dimension. When he asked, what did you see? She saw gods coming out of the earth. That's why when people call upon God, you have to know which one. Because the Bible said there are many gods. And so I thank God that he has laid some structures in his word that we can know the spirits that are operating, whether it is of him or whether it is not of him. And this is a season for a lot of encounters. And she said, I saw gods ascending out of the earth. And he said unto her, what form is he of? And she said, an old man cometh up, and he is covered with a mantle. And Saul perceived that it was Samuel. And he stooped with his face to the ground and bowed himself. I just want to, you know, balance it out here a little bit. And I won't really go into all what Samuel had to say to him. But the thing is, when you read it, you will realize that what Samuel actually said to him was nothing new. The judgment of God that was already upon his life, which was pronounced to him by Samuel, all Samuel did was to bring him into remembrance of it. Because what God have said concerning a people, a nation, he will do.
And so what God have already said concerning you, whether or not the devil comes and give a contrary report, what God says will stand. And so even though the spirit came up, the words did not change. I want you to know today that this was an encounter not to bring glory to God, but this was an encounter out of fear. This was an encounter with the very thing that he had them to cut off. And so today, this is what the enemy, in the midst of the encounters that God wants to give to his people, this is what the enemy is aspiring to do. To bring you into a place where the word of the Lord and the life that God has asked you to live, you will live contrary to it, so that when you are pressed down and you don't know where to turn, then you find you will look for an open door. And most times the open doors that you will look for will not be a divine door. I mean, it's a sad thing to say, but there are people who sit in church and they still go to the Gade. There are people who sit in church and they still go to the Obia man. They have charms in their neck. They have it in their purse. My God, they have it inside of their shoes. They go to work and they get a job. And fear that they may lose the job, they sprinkle things. Listen to me. You have no idea the sort of encounters that people have in the dark. But I said to you today, I just need you to understand that there are godly encounters, but there are some encounters you ought not to get yourself involved in. And I use this scripture today so that you will understand what brought him to that place. You see, when God turns his back, he really turns his back. You cannot walk into disobedience and want to see the healing power of God. You cannot be living anyhow and want to see his glory. My God, listen to me, somebody. Don't let the devil fool you. You got to understand the lifestyle that is required of you so that the blessings of God can come upon your life. I am talking to somebody here today. And even if you are viewing online, I am coming right where you are. You see, because there are persons that began well with God. They called upon him, and when they turned their back on him, my God, and his blessings stop, they cannot be humble enough to go back to him, but they need people to see, I am still able and capable of living that lifestyle. And they turn around to a different encounter. Listen to me here today. He got to that place because of his disobedience. And the very thing, and this is what happens, when you do not understand who you are in God, and you allow yourself to go contrary to who God is, the very thing that you run away from, that is why I have heard people come and give great testimonies of what God has done, the goodness of God, healing in their body, London, all of that, and I rejoice with them. But when these people stop walking the walk and talking the talk, my God, and they get too big for their own good, and they become swell-headed, and that which they have, they forgot that it was the Lord who gave it to them, and it then is taken away from them. Pride have already stepped in, and so they still need to continue that life, and so some of them will go to the ends no matter what. So the very thing that they testified against, the very thing that they said, Father, thank you for taking me out of it, they step right back into it. It is like a man going back to his vomit. And we see Saul going back to inquire of the very things that he asked that they should get rid of in the country. My God. And when you read lower down, you will find out that the answer remained the same. The prophet did not tell him anything different. Rather, the prophet said to him, this is what I said to you, even when I was alive, that God was going to do. And this is exactly what is going to happen. So I want to encourage somebody here today. Let no one make you think that if you move away from God, the story that will come to you will be a good story. If the Lord says you ought to repent and you don't repent, his word stands sure. And so going over to the dark side, you may think you get a temporary relief, but what you have done is that you have just added to a curse that is already upon your life. And so Saul did not get the result that he was looking for. And the word of the Lord still came to pass. The kingdom was taken from him and it was given to David. Glory be to God. But all is not lost. Hallelujah. As I look, my God, as I look in the book of Acts, Acts chapter 9, picking up the reading from verse 4. Glory be to God this morning. Hallelujah. I want to look at another man named Saul. Hey, today we are in the Saul's head today. I want to look at a man who was pursuing, who was after Christians. He was zealous for what he was doing. The ones that he answered to, my God, he wanted to do a good job. He wanted to do a great job. And because of that, he believed what he was doing to be right. And so therefore, this man pursued the Christians. And he wanted to kill, put in prison. Listen, he wanted to do away with every one of them that called upon the name of Jesus. To every one of them, hallelujah, that said that Jesus Christ is Lord. I'm just going to run quickly with this one, picking up the reading from verse 1. And Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest. So it was not enough to just threaten the people of God back then, but he went unto the high priest and he desired of him letters to Damascus, to the synagogues, that if he found any of his way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound into Jerusalem. When you have a perception of a thing, when you believe in it, there is nothing you will not do to support your belief. And this is what was happening here to this man. He really believed in his heart that he was doing the right thing. And so he wanted to ensure he did it to the best of his ability. And so in those days, the Christians were talking about Jesus, the Nazarene. And so this in his air was blasphemy. And so in his place and power that he had, he sought to get even more by having letters given to him with a greater level of authorization that he may hunt them down. But the Bible says in verse 3, as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. I am here this morning to talk about encounters briefly. This is a man that had a perception, an idea, a thought of doing something that he followed on, believing it to be so. But God looked beyond the man that was doing, and he looked at the heart of that man. And God knew if he brought a balance to that man, then that man could have been shifted in another direction. That is why we don't judge people. You don't know why a man or a woman is doing what they're doing or why they are where they are at this time. And so all we know is what they have done. That's all we can talk about. Their flaws, their shortcomings, who beat who shot who killed who. And while we are doing this, the Lord is looking at the heart of that man. He's looking at the source of the information. He's looking at the company that person kept to have paved that way for them. And so when God looked at him, he said, okay, I'm going to give this man an encounter. You see, God is going to give you an opportunity to change the way you think. He is going to give you an opportunity to shift drift a bit from the path that you are walking on. Why? Because God knows that some of you who's walking that path and doing the things that you are doing is because of the perception that you have, is because of the crowd that you're following, and it is because of the belief system that you have embraced. And so you find the Lord decide to give Paul an encounter, and his was a divine encounter, because the Bible said as he journeyed, because you gotta be on a journey, you can't be sitting in one place for anything to happen. There must be movement on your part. You have to be doing something. God, sometimes you have to know how to begin to do something that will cause God by his spirit to begin to move on your behalf. And so there came a light, because you have to understand that where Paul was, he was in a dark place. Where he was, the things that he was doing was not bringing glory to God. So when you are in a place, my God, where what you are doing is contrary to the will of God, to the mind and the purpose of God, there must be a light that will come to illuminate the darkness. There must be a light that will shine over you, that clarity may come to you. Somebody, you gotta know what I'm talking about today. Listen to me. When the light comes, the darkness is exposed. And the light came, and that light shone around him. My God, the Bible didn't say it shone around the men that was with him. I said to you, when you are in the crowd and you have a desire for God, he will touch you in the crowd. He will come to you in the midst of everybody else. My God, they may not see it coming, because the Bible tells me that the men heard a voice, but they didn't even see anybody. When your encounter comes, you alone will know that it is my encounter. Why? Because you know what you are asking. You know what you are praying for, and somebody has been praying for you. Somebody is saying, God, turn her around, turn him around. My God, somebody listen. That is why we don't give up on people. The light came, and it shone around him, and it was a light from heaven. Not a light from a man. It was a light from heaven. Because when men shine light upon you, they know how to shut it off. If you do something that they don't like, or they got upset with you, they put you in the spotlight, they gave you a title, even on the job. But if you step on their feet, they feel they can take it away. But when God shines his light upon you, no devil in hell, out of hell, can take away that spotlight. Why? Because it came from a heavenly place. Am I talking to somebody here today? Hallelujah. And he fell to the earth. You see, you understand something. I'm going to pull some nuggets from my apostle here today. I know he has more, so I can take some from him. You see, Paul, because of his stature, because of where he was seated high, and those that gave him the authority was even higher than him, it was necessary for God to bring him down to the ground. Some of you, that encounter will catapult you. And before you get to the other level, you will be on your face. Before you get to that other level, your eyelashes will come out. Your wig will fall from your head. You may break a nail. You might smudge the makeup. But when God is about getting ready to deal with you, he will show you that I am God. Get out from on that high horse. Who do you think you are? Because you have a job, you have the money, and you can choose whatever you want to eat. You think you are it? I am getting ready to humble you. I am getting ready to bring you down. I am getting ready to let you know that no flesh can glory in my presence. Karamandurubo. Rakatatayata. God is getting ready to tell somebody, know your place. It is I am God. That's why when they persecute them, Pastor Lynch on the job, don't be like them. Lift up your voice, because there is a God. Remember Haman? Haman had a plan to kill all the Jews, and he just thought he was going to get away with it. later. But let me tell you the story. He was hanged on the very gallows that he built for Mordecai. When encounters come your way and God is the one in control, the very thing that your enemy set for you, they will be falling in it. The very trap that they set for you, that trap is going to hold them in bondage. Why? Because it is not you, it is the Lord. So don't you bother with people who appear to be high and lifted up. God knows how to get them down. He knows how to keep them down. Mandarabande. Hey, my God, I'm getting excited up in here. And he fell to the earth. And a voice spoke to him. Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? You see, because when people look at you as a believer, they think they're coming up against you. But they're coming up against the God that you serve. They're coming up against the one who called you by name. They're coming up against the one who said, I knew you from in your mother's womb. That is who they're coming up against. My God, not you. When they look again, they will see a giant standing behind you. God is getting ready to give some people, my God, some encounters in this season that will cause all those that are on the high places in your life to bow down. And if you happen to be in a high place, my God, you will have to come down. You will come crashing down. Hey. And the greater your destiny, the greater your destiny, the harder will be your fall. Hey, listen to me, somebody. But the fall will do you good. Thank you, Sister Flo. The fall will do you good. And he said, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, who art thou, Lord? So you know there was a Lord. You knew. Listen to me. Some people know, but because of the belief, because, listen, of the perception of what they believe, they will mash up your house. They will wait by you to shoot you. Why? Because of what they believe. So he said, Lord, who art thou? And the Lord says, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. And the Bible said in verse 6, and he trembling and astonished, because an encounter will leave you astonished. An encounter will leave you bowed down. No one can say to me, I had an encounter and I walked away the same way. Oh, no, 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 no. An encounter is going to leave you naked but unashamed. Ah! An encounter is going to strip you. Professor Papius, it's going to take you out. Take out that cloak. Take it out. Take out your pride. Take you out. Even take the money that you think you had. Take the car. Take the house. Take the land. Take the husband. Take the wife. Listen to me. Sometimes take the children. You think you are it. An encounter is going to bring you face to face with the Most High God. And that encounter is going to break you. But glory be to God. When it breaks you, it is going to make you again. It is not going to break you to leave you the same, but it's going to break you. Matarakata. So at the end of it, you will be the you that you are born to be. My God, that which you want, the encounter is going to take you out, strip you, put bones on you again, breathe on you again. When people look at you, they will not know that was the same you, because that encounter will cause you to have a walk you never had before. It's going to have you to have a move you never had before. That encounter will solidify you. That encounter will mature you. That encounter will open your spiritual eyes. Hey. Anamasoto. Anamande. Amen. That encounter, Anamato, will not leave you the same. Anamama, mama, mama. we know I'm talking about divine encounters. But I had an encounter not with a divine, but with a man sitting there. And I'm still there 30 years. My God, what an encounter. Hey, this man came good. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, we say God is good. Oh, this man is good. This man came with some things that I needed. This man came to shock me. This man came to do something different. This man came with a different ideology. This man came with a different concept. This man came as someone I didn't know before. Ah, this man came. And I'm still there after 30 years. My God, that was an encounter. Hallelujah. Now, if a man can do that, how much more God? Hey, how much more God? Somebody get ready for your encounter. I don't care how your mama had it. I don't care how your daddy had it. But there is an encounter that is coming to you today to change everything that you thought you knew. Hey, my God. Jesus. Hey. And he was trembling and he was astonished. You see, because where there are powers, anytime the greater power shows up, the lesser power got to bow. Listen to me. He thought he was that power, Pastor Lynch, because I have letters from the uplines and I can do what I want. But he was not ready for a greater one. And that greater power did not just appear, but it brought him on his face. Listen to me. I believe his head must have gone halfway through the ground, because God knows how to make an entrance. Jesus knows how to tell. My God, those that are persecuting you, those that have shut the door, he knows how to let them know that he is the God that you serve. He's gonna do it in such a way that if you're not careful, you might feel sorry for them, because he is not gonna do it in hidden places. He is going to make a public show of them. We're talking about a divine encounter here today. My God, my God, my God. And when he was broken, trembling and astonished, Lord, what will thou have me do? That is why I say, you cannot have an encounter and be the same. Because when that encounter hits you, you will realize that your way, your style, your design was nothing. Papi show, nonsense, not good. Maji, kakapul, not good. So then you will say, Lord, what will you have me do? This is what I gave up for all those years. My God, I think I had it made. Father, it is nothing. That is why when the man of God had an encounter, he said, everything that I have learned, I consider it as dung, poop. The Apostle Paul, Gamaliel, he sat at the feet of one of the greatest teachers. But when he had his encounter, he looked back at his earthly education, Pavlos Papius, and he said, nah, all of that is poop. My God, I know nothing. And God wants you to have an encounter where your HBAs and your BBCs and all of these things, my God, will look like nothing in the face of God. You might even want to burn it because you realize that there is a God with a status of your name on it that is higher than where you are. You will realize that the whole house you bill and you want to shoot people, you put some signs, don't pass. My God, you will understand that there is a mansion that he have, and you are going to walk on streets of gold, and you notice you cannot make a comparison with that. Hey, shatara kondorobo. Jesus, arise and go into the city. That is when your direction will come. Some of you, the direction cannot come because you are still standing. You don't even know how to bow down. Today, look at this atmosphere. Today, that was an atmosphere of glory. In the presence of angels, we've got glory on the winds. Listen to me. When it begin to move, some of you didn't even understand that when you heard the word glory and presence, you gotta bow down. Your head have to go somewhere. But you remain as if you don't even know where you are. It is only when the encounter comes and hits you down, and this encounter comes to leave you astonished and trembling, that is when you will say to God, Lord, what will thou have me do? Until then, you still sit with your arrogant self. You still move with your backbiting mouth. You still size people up. You still think that you are better than somebody else because they go for a bus and you drive. You better get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Because God is going to give the same ones you turn your nose upon, the same ones that you look down, the same ones you probably laugh at what they are wearing. God is about getting ready to cause an ascension to come. He is getting ready, because all the time you see them there, they are in the backside of the desert. God is dealing with them in his own way. He is not dealing with you so you think nothing is happening, but in their heart they are saying, God, I need change. Father, do something. They are crying out to God, and you don't know that, but with your judging self, you just look at them. My God, listen to me. There is an encounter, a glory encounter, that is coming to the people of God to transform you, but it begins on the inside. It begins on the inside. And the men who journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice but seeing no man. Before I stop talking, let me say this to you. When you know what your desires of God, shut your ear to the crowd. The crowd don't know what you are saying on the inside. The crowd does not even have a vision of where they're going, Evangelist Stephanie. All the crowd knows is that they just look at you, and you come, you look good, so what? She have it all together, and why isn't she doing more? But the crowd does not know that in your quiet times, weeping may endure for a night, but there is a joy that comes in the morning. The crowd don't understand when they see you coming, even though every day you cannot testify as yet, but you still coming because you know that your day of encounter is coming. The crowd wants to push you. The crowd wants to nudge you. The crowd wants you to talk before your time. The crowd wants you to challenge authority. The crowd will tell you, you deserve this and you deserve that. But you know that you are believing God to do something supernatural. And so that is why, when you know that you know that you know, you are not moved with the crowd. And when the crowd see you doing some things differently, they may stand in amazement. But let me tell you this, your eyes are not on the crowd. Because you know that there is a day of reckoning. You were not born to be where you are today. The place that you are have become too small. There are gifts, there are abilities, there are potentials wrapped up in you. And that encounter will force it to come to the surface. That encounter will propel you to be transformed. That encounter will break barriers. That encounter will break limitations. That encounter will transform you into another man, into another woman. While the crowd continues to just look on. My God. And they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. I want to stop there, my God. I want my apostle to come and just look. Catapult some things that is still in there. There is so much more. When that encounter comes, if you read, you will see God had already prepared a man named Ananias. A man who had his own perception of Paul because of what he was hearing. People will have their own perception of you because of what they have heard about you. Don't trust him. Don't trust her. That's a homebreaker. She took this person's husband. She did this. He did that. But when God is the one who speaks, heaven and earth shall pass away. But his word can never pass away. God had to tell Ananias, it's not about what you have heard. It's not about what even you have seen with your eyes. But it is about what I am getting ready to do. Somebody listen to me. God is getting ready to cause a transformation power and an encounter that will come with you, that will shift you into another realm, into another dimension. My God, listen, you have cried enough. You have shouted enough. Stand with me for one second. But God have his angels ready to give you that encounter that you deserve. Mary was minding her business. She was espoused to a man, and here came the angel calling her, Hail Mary, letting her know that she was highly favored. The woman did not understand what was happening, but out of that woman, my God, God chose to bring forth Jesus. When the encounter comes, the impossible shall begin to happen in your life. When the encounter comes, you can be in Denry, you can be in Olio, you can be across the waters, you can be sitting by the bar, you can be by the beach. When that encounter comes, there will be a heavenly visitation, and after that visitation, you can no longer be the same, you can no longer walk the same. No longer changes, your walk changes, your posture changes, your position changes, your appetite changes. Everything about you changes, and people wonder, who does she think she is? Who does he think he is? But at that point, you are not looking at them. All you know is that there was an encounter by a person. All you know that there was an encounter. My God, somebody. All you know, enamato rakatata yande, that an encounter had come to you just where you are. And it's an encounter of transformation that will cause you to be the woman that God has called you to be. Some of you, the encounter may touch your brains and your ability for God to use you in the place of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You may just get up and suddenly you are speaking great words, words you have never heard before. You have become a problem solver. You're suddenly with your encounter is going to transform you for the better. God bless you today. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus. And there is much more coming your way.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. When we speak about encounters, come on, good word, prophetess. I don't know where you're going yet. I don't know where you're going yet, but when we speak about encounters, we speak about an especially divine encounter. We are speaking about having an orchestrated meeting. Simply means that God sets it up.
Yes. Come on.
Simply means it has been inspired by God.
Yes.
And so when Saul had that encounter, yes, the first Saul, King Saul, when he had his first encounter with the prophet, it was inspired by God.
Amen.
Because when he met the prophet Samuel, it was an inspiration of God, because God spoke to Samuel concerning King Saul.
Yes.
And Saul was not yet king, but God had spoken to Samuel about a king who was coming. My God.
Hallelujah.
And then all of the preparation was made for Saul before he became king. My God.
Come on.
And so the meat was prepared in the house of a man for Saul when he had the encounter.
Amen.
And then in the process of time, the scripture also teaches us that the same Saul who had an encounter with a prophet that was divinely ordained, he found himself having an encounter with a witch. He found himself having an encounter with something God had told them to destroy. But my God, there is always a way that something remains, my God, to test and to prove us.
Amen.
My God, and so here was King Saul, who had an encounter with God,
yes,
who knew who God was, who was nothing before the encounter, and yet God, my God, established him as king,
yes,
when he was not even, my God, called by his family to be king. Isn't it funny how God sometimes can qualify you when your family has disqualified you?
Yes.
And so here was Saul, who was not yet king, but God called him a king.
Amen.
And God orchestrated a man to meet with him.
Yes.
My God, God caused even the donkey, my God, to be lost. And here he was in search of something that God had already orchestrated. My God, there are some things that you have lost, not because you wanted to lose it, but God allow it to go so that you can have a divine encounter.
Hallelujah.
And somebody in this house need to have a divine encounter. Some of you need to understand the reason why you have lost some things.
Yes.
It's not because you wanted to lose it, but God orchestrated it so that you could have been in the right place at the right time. My God. And so here was Saul with a young man who understood honor. And my God, you can have a seat for a minute. We're coming to you in a minute. Hallelujah. And here was a young man who was with King Saul.
Yes.
And Saul said, well, I have nothing because I heard in order to go to the prophet, you have to have something in your hand.
Amen.
But the young man said, I'm carrying something.
Hey.
It's important sometimes for others to be carrying something
when
the leader does not have it. Because God will orchestrate some people that will have what you don't have. But you have to understand that these people have been assigned to you.
Amen. Come on. Hallelujah.
The young man was not pompous. The young man was not out of control. But he said, I have what you need to get to the prophet.
Yes.
Because in a divine encounter, God always allows someone who have what you don't have that you can have an encounter with a divine God. And so here was King Saul having an encounter with a prophet. And here he go. My God, when he could not have heard another word from a prophet or even from God, he found himself going to a witch.
Hey. Ouch.
Can I talk to somebody?
Go ahead.
My God, when the oil run out,
Jesus,
you better know who you're going to. Because there are situations that will dry the oil from off of your life.
Amen.
But you have to know how to access that oil that appeared to have been dried. Because someone is calling the lead off of that bottle.
Woo.
My God, tell somebody, I'm going to wait until the oil begins to flow again. Somebody needs to know that that oil can flow again.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Prophetess, my God, look at somebody and tell them the oil will flow again. My God, you
again.
Better look at somebody.
Yes.
My God, because the woman felt that she did not have any more oil in the house. She didn't know what she had in the house. My God, she thought that the house was empty until she had an encounter with a divine. My God, somebody understand that God is going to cause you to have encounters with the divine. And when we speak about the divine, we're speaking about the mouthpiece of God.
Amen. Come on.
Let's go for a minute.
Go ahead.
My God, prophetess, we're preaching today. My God, here it was.
Go ahead.
That this woman. No oil, nothing in the house.
Mm.
Husband died, but she didn't know that she had some oil in the house. Here was this woman. My God, she didn't know that what she had in the house that was well covered, it was well sealed. That meant it was not running. And there's some folks that are well covered. They're well sealed. They're not running. But God will give you an encounter with the divine. Because it's time for you to come forth.
Amen. Come on.
My God, right there in the house, her husband was there but died. But he left something in the house. The man of God will never leave you without something in
the house. Hallelujah.
If there is nothing in the house, you've not had an encounter with the man of God.
Amen. Amen. Ooh, Jesus.
And so here, Saul, look, encounter. But here he was. There was no voice again. The prophet was not there anymore. There was no Urim that he could have spoken to.
Nope.
My God, not even the voice of God. The heavens were shut above him.
Hey.
He could not even dream anymore. There's some folks in the early stages of their ministry and walk with God, they were dreaming. But suddenly everything just gets dry and it gets dreary.
Amen.
And they blame everybody else but themselves. But you have to dig deep on the inside, because it is still locked up on the inside, but just waiting for you to say, come forth. Because out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Somebody say the oil, it will flow.
Amen.
My God, we are talking about divine encounters.
Hallelujah.
So here was King Saul.
Go ahead.
Before he became king, he met the man of God.
Amen.
But when he became king, he met the witch. There are some folks before they got saved.
Go ahead,
they met with God.
Yes.
But after salvation, when things begin to fall apart, they find themselves going in places they should not go. Connecting with people they should not connect. But here was the king in his position of authority, yet did not understand that it was dried up because of his.
Amen.
Some of you, your oil have been dried up, not because of someone, but because of you.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Quickly. We are running.
Glory be to God.
We are running. So here, prophetess, King Saul and Saul, who became Paul, the Saul who persecuted the church.
Yes.
My God, while he was Saul, he ripped some havoc.
Yes, he did.
But the king, while he was king, he messed up some things.
Yes.
But Saul, while he was Saul, he messed up some things.
Yes.
But here he came into contact with the King of Kings.
Yes.
And he said, Lord, what would you have me do?
Hey.
Can I really talk it?
Go ahead, Apostle.
And so, prophetess, the Saul in Acts had an encounter with the Lord himself.
Amen.
Bowed down.
Yes.
Because my God, he was on a horse.
Yes.
And he felt that he was mighty. He was on a horse. And he felt that he was it. He was the man. Until he came in contact with the real man. Until he came in contact with a man that was greater than him.
Amen.
And he had to submit to the authority of that man.
Amen.
And my God, he recognized who he was. And he said, what will you have me do?
Yes.
Somebody, you need to ask God, what would you have me do?
Amen.
What would you have me do? The crowd is behind me.
Yes.
But they're behind me for the wrong reason.
My God. Woo. Go ahead.
And so here he was, Saul, have an encounter with Jesus.
Amen.
While he was Saul.
Yes. Hey. Hallelujah.
And folks said that unsaved cannot have an encounter with God.
My God.
While he was Saul,
he had an encounter with Jesus. Because salvation comes when you're not saved.
Amen.
But the processes of interference will come after salvation.
Amen.
And so here he was when his name was changed from Saul to Paul. My God, he had an encounter.
Hallelujah. Glory.
Saul, the king, had an encounter with the witch. Paul, or Saul, who became Paul, had an encounter with a serpent.
Go ahead.
One was subtle. Because the serpent is subtle.
Very.
But the serpent bit him.
Yes, it did.
In the presence of the barbarians.
Yes.
So folks were looking and expecting him to die.
Yes.
Expecting him to swell up. Here was Saul, king, not hearing a word, approaching the witch, not understanding she did not have what he needed.
My God.
She could have accessed a realm, but what he needed, she did not have it.
Nope.
The only person that had what he needed was God. And here was Paul, who had what the generation needed. And so when the serpent bit him, my God, the barbarians looked at him and said, "You better die just now."
Go ahead, Apostle. My God.
Hear what? Somebody need to stand to their feet. Somebody need to stand to their feet. Hear what? When we speak about a divine encounter, prophetess.
Go ahead, apostle.
We are speaking about having an encounter.
Yes.
With a personal thing that God have appointed for you to meet with.
Amen.
And so here you are. Many of you came today to have an encounter.
Yes.
Divine. Many of you came here today to have an encounter with God.
Amen.
And many folks who are around you don't know what you came to have an encounter with.
Amen.
Folks around you don't even know what your needs are.
Hallelujah.
But yet you came in the house with desperation. You came in the house with a hunger.
Yes.
You came in the house with a thirst.
Yes.
And my God, God is going to quench that thirst that you have.
Come on.
And so while you're in the house, you better forget about your neighbor.
Amen.
You better forget about the person behind you and say, "I came to meet with my maker."
Amen.
Somebody lift your hand to heaven and make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Hallelujah, go ahead, prophet. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
I speak over your life today that you are going to have encounters that you're not even prepared for. I speak over your life today that you're going to have encounters that only God can establish. You are going to have encounters that only God can create. Your mind cannot comprehend the encounters that God will cause you to come into. My God, your eyes have not been able even to see the encounters or the magnitude of encounters that you are going to have. My God, those who looked at you and say you, they don't know and they don't understand what God is doing for you and with you, I declare over you today that they will see the hand of God, they will see the power of God, and then they shall know that it is God who have done it for you, with you, and through you.
Hallelujah. Woo. Sharabosa.
Rest your hand on your
Hallelujah.
Head for a minute.
Glory be to God.
Just rest your hand on your head.
Jesus.
Wherever you are. And just repeat after me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
My mind.
My mind.
My spirit.
My spirit.
My brains.
My brains.
Will comprehend.
Will comprehend.
What you have in store for me.
What you have in store for
my brains.
My brains.
Will come to terms.
Will come to terms.
And come into alignment.
Come into alignment.
With your spirit.
With your spirit.
And that which you have planned.
That which you have planned.
For my life.
For my life.
For my destiny.
For my destiny.
I will see it.
I will see it.
I will visualize it.
I will visualize
it. My mind will come into order.
My mind will come
with my vision.
With my vision.
And your vision for me.
And your vision.
My God, from this day onward,
I will see it as you have revealed it.
I will see it as you have shown it. I will not be moved by the thoughts of others, but I will be moved only by your word, only by your thoughts. I declare today in your name that my dreams, that my visions, that my goals, that my imaginations will come to terms with who you are and that which you have planned for my life. I declare today my mind will go beyond my generation. My mind will go beyond yesterday's issue. My mind will go forth into the place, God, that you have designed for my mind to reach, to be established. My God, somebody just lay your hands upon your head and you begin to speak to your brains, begin to speak to your mind, begin to speak to your spirit, and command an acceleration. My God, there shall be rapid accelerations in your mind. There shall be rapid accelerations in your imagination. My God, you will comprehend the things of God, not the way you did before, but at a higher level. My God, my God, just keep your hands on your head. I see some things being uprooted. I see some strongholds being pulled down. Just lift your hand, just lift your hand. Ushers, just get ready. Just get ready, ushers, just look around. My God, because God is breaking some people through. Rika Tana Mashanda. My God, God is breaking some of you through. My God, listen to me. Just rest your hand. Just lift your hand. Leave your hand on your head. Just leave it right there. My God, in just a few seconds, some of you are going to feel the presence of the Lord just dropping. Some of you are going to feel like a wind just blowing. Some of you are going to feel like a fire on the inside. Some of you are just going to feel a hand just touching you. My God, just lift your hand. Just lift your hand right there on your head. Leave your hand right there. Touch, Lord. Touch. Touch God to the right. Touch your people right here. Touch your people right now. My God. Touch your people.
Touch now, God. Touch now, Father, all those that are viewing.
Let the wind blow
in house. Father, touch them by the power of the anointing. Father, touch, break every barrier that is around in the minds, around the lives of your people. Father, let divinity fresh fire. Fresh fire now, God.
Some of you just need to walk up to the altar.
Fresh fire.
Just walk up to the altar with your hands on your head.
Father, touch it now, God, on my left. Touch it now, God, on my right. Father, drop it. Now upon them, Lord, let there be some fresh encounters, some new encounters. It's happening right here. Father, touch now, drop upon your people, drop upon them now, God. There is an open heaven.
You are not going to lose your mind.
There are angels in this place, God, today. Ratashiku.
You are not going to lose your mind.
Yes, Lord.
You are not going to lose your mind. You are not going to go off. That devil will go. Anamashando. He will be driven out. Out of your head, out of your mind. He will be driven out. Kariando Robo Shanda. He will be driven out. Kadabasha. Rakataya Sunde. That thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, against the knowledge of God, it shall be brought low. It shall be brought low. Touch, touch, touch. Touch now. Touch now. Kadabashike. Reketelebe.
Lord, let an encounter come.
Come on, he will touch you. He will touch you. Don't wait for me. Don't wait for the prophet. Don't wait for the leader. He will touch you. He will touch you. He will fill you up. He will establish you. My God, what he has planned for you, you will know. You will see it. It may be bigger than you, but you will have a glimpse of it. It may be bigger than you, but you're going to have a glimpse. You're going to have a glimpse of it. He will show it to you. My God, you'll have glimpses.
Father, an encounter, God, your glory, an encounter to lift up every burden. An encounter is happening now to shift every anxiety out of the way. An encounter is happening now to break every spirit of unbelief. An encounter is happening now to cause fresh strength to come upon you. An encounter is happening now to cause you to believe the impossible. An encounter is coming now to break generational curses. An encounter is coming now to strengthen your inner man. An encounter is happening now to give you a sense of direction. An encounter is coming now to get rid of the words of negativity that has been spoken over your life. For there have been words that have you bound, but there is an encounter happening now to break the words, to break the chains, to break the fetters of the enemy. There is an encounter that is happening to you now to pull you out of every pit, to pull you out of every dungeon, to pull you out of whatever prison that of the mind, prison of the soul. There is an encounter taking place right here at this altar, and that encounter is breaking the back of some words. I give heavy words, words that say you are not going to make it, words that say you are not going to have it, words that say you will never get married, words that say you don't deserve it. There is an encounter here that is breaking, that is breaking, break, 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 Lord. Break those words of negativity over the minds of your people. Break it now by your spirit. Break it now. Speak to the Lord. Speak to him today. For there are angels right here at this altar. Every mind bind the devil. Be broken. Every spirit of anxiety. Every spirit of depression. Every spirit of doubt. Loose the mind of the people of God right now. Loose their wills. Every emotional wounds. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody push at the altar there today. For it is the Lord that is doing it by his spirit. Father, let there be an encounter today.
my God, to open doors that the enemy has shut in the minds of your people, in the doors that the enemy has shut in their destiny. There is an encounter coming right now at you to cause wisdom, to cause knowledge, to cause revelation to come to you. Some of you are there out there today. You want some words to know what to do. You want words of direction. Some of you are in the valley of decision. There are some decisions that you have to make, and there is an encounter that is going to take place right here at this altar to point you in the right direction. Somebody push, somebody push. Make use of the water that is troubled at the altar there today. And if you are in your home, wherever you are, begin to push. There are angels moving in this place. Akanamanda ramanda rakadoshe kekere lesete rababababasundo rekanamamamamama. I see the Lord lifting every impossibility from off your mind. I see the Lord shifting you into a higher dimension. I see the Lord going before you today and opening doors of opportunity even before you. I see for some of you, the Spirit of the Lord is traveling. He is even going beyond St. Lucia to take some things that belong to you and to cause you to come into an inheritance. He is going to cause you to possess your possession. I see the Spirit of the Lord is beginning to deal with some people that have some things concerning you on lockdown. I say push at this altar. There is an encounter where you are going to start dreaming dreams. You are going to start having visions, visions of the day, visions of the night. Some of you on this altar here, you have been praying not for yourself, but you have been praying for family, for children. I see the Lord coming to give you words, coming to give you directions in a vision, in a dream. Come on, somebody push. Oh, some of you are very close. Push a little. You don't care who is next to you. You don't care standing by you, but somebody need to push. For some of you, I see some papers sign. For some of you, I see some promotions are coming to you. Some of you, I see you in new houses, shifting. I see God changing some of your locations right now. I see the Lord going through the generation of some of you today and breaking some generational curses, breaking it. Some things that have been holding you back, some things that have you bound. But today, in that day of divine encounters, the Lord is confronting the giants. The Lord is coming against the Goliaths, the Philistines that have come in and taken what belonged to you. I smell in the realm of the spirit a spirit of loss, a spirit of grief, because some of you have lost some things have been taken away. I can smell it in the realm of the spirit, but I see the Lord, I see the Lord high and lifted up, and he is getting ready, my God, to do battle on your behalf. Even some of you, some decisions that you have made and you are not sure if it was the right decision, I see the Lord coming to give you an encounter, coming to give you a visitation to bring clarity to the decision that you have made. Come on, somebody, push by this altar here today. The Lord says, is there anything too hard for me? The Lord says, the water is troubled. The Lord says, speak to me, Zion. Speak to me, my people. Don't just wait to be prayed to or to be prayed for, but begin to speak. I see some of you will begin to travel again.
again. Rakatote masatata. I see the Lord opening some doors of traveling for some of you out there. And to do that, the Lord is confronting some things that have been blocking you. Ekete rakoto monde mekete yete. Yes, the Lord is removing blockages. The Lord is breaking down some walls of Jericho. I hear the Lord say, trust in me. The Lord say, rest in me. The Lord says, I will do it. I am begun doing it, and I will continue. I see some of you getting some news. Some of you getting some good news. Some of you standing here, you believe that it has been so long that you have been waiting. It might not happen, but the Lord says, watch me in this encounter. I see God restoring. There is a restoration that is taking place. God is restoring some years that were taken from you. I see tears. Some of you have cried. You have been crying so much that your tears are coming up before God like a wall. Your tears have so many things in it. But I see God gathering those tears. And He's saying, I am going to answer. I am going to answer. I am going to answer. I don't know. But if you know you have been praying, then God is getting ready to answer.
Prophetess. This morning, the Lord just reminded me that this morning in the service, He said that there are women with fibroids in this house that are going to experience miracles. I don't know how many of you are dealing with fibroid issues. The Lord says that you are going to experience your miracle.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Because what I saw this morning is some women, their tummy just swells.
Hey.
And they feel a sudden movement in the tummy. It's almost as if they're having they have a child.
Come on.
Speak, and their discomforts on one side. Continually, because there's a woman who's here and she's been having discomforts more or less on one side.
Hey.
I don't know who you are. I don't know
speak
who you
Lord,
are.
Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord.
That's you.
Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. You did it for me, God. You can do it again. You did it for me, Lord. You can do it
but,
again.
But a few of you, who you two, come. If this is you.
Yeah. Come. You did it for me, Lord. You can do it again.
Because the Lord brought me back into the time where I prayed for a particular woman.
Yes.
And prophetess, she has never been in church.
Come on.
But she got healed of that fibroid immediately.
Hallelujah. Ooh.
And there are miracles that are going to take place.
Yes.
And it's going to be immediately.
Amen.
Some of you, even online, are going to experience some immediate healing.
Amen.
If you can believe the word of the Lord, my God, you will have your miracle.
Hallelujah.
I was praying for someone on this side. And the Lord said to leave her.
Yes.
And go and deal with this.
Amen. Go ahead. Go ahead, Apostle.
Who has fibroid? Where are you? All of you women dealing with fibroid. If you're online, you can just say I. You can just type I if you're online. You have a fibroid issue. You're having pain on one side. Who's having the pains on one side? You? There's somebody else. You? Take some oil and just anoint them. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Run with the oil. Come, bring the oil for me. Bring the oil for me.
Healing is in the house.
Put the oil, put it in my hand.
Healing is in the house.
Kalima Shandodobu Shanda. Father, by the power of your spirit,
yes, Kashina
This shall be a representation of your anointing.
Yes, Lord.
And the yokes, God, upon your people.
Yes, Lord.
The yoke of fibroid.
Yes.
It shall be destroyed.
Yes.
And God, those women that are incapable of producing because of the fibroid, Father, I decree, God, that that hole shall be broken. That curse shall be destroyed. By the power of the Holy Ghost, by the Spirit of the living God, I decree, God, today that even as this all touches them, and Father, those online, I decree, God, today that they are partakers, God, of this miracle. In the name of Jesus, touch right now by the power and by the Spirit of the living God. Ikata, rekatana bashando, riskataya, reke, reketu, nasanda.
I say, receive your healing for all those viewing online. Receive your healing now, wherever you are, wherever you are. Enameski, rakoto roboshi kanamande. Receive your healing. Receive your healing now. In the name of Jesus.
There's a woman here. There was one of you here who cried because of that pain. Because of that pain. You cried because of that pain. That fibroid pain. Where you? That's you. That's you, mom. That's you. Just lift your hand.
The power of God
is a miracle working God. There is nothing that he cannot do.
Healing.
I'm hearing someone saying, I want to have that child. I'm hearing you. I hear you say, I want to give birth to my husband's child. Kadima sha.
Rabato repete inamando. Do it, Lord.
Because you're actually fearful of having your womb removed.
Touch, Father, by your power, by your anointing. Touch, Lord.
Pastor Mason, come.
Miracles, signs, wonders. For those
just
online,
touch the tummy
online,
of these women.
God with us here today. Just lay
just
your hands
touch the tummy
on the womb. If you don't have olive oil and you have cooking oil, just put some in your hand. For those online, my God, there is an anointing. There's a miracle.
I am seeing women who have cysts.
Hey.
And one got pregnant at one time.
Go ahead.
And lost that child. Kalima Shanda. Nakatada Bashikoto Robo. Indandoske Teyanda. My God.
Father, let that anointing find them wherever they are. Let that anointing penetrate them.
I'm hearing a woman saying, I want to get pregnant. I want to have my child. I'm hearing you. You see, God knows how to touch. God knows how to meet us at our point and place of need. I'm hearing a woman saying, will I be able to give birth to my husband's child when he shows up? Go. Fibroid. We call you out. We command you to go. Now. Pass and go. Now. Nasakataya. Irobo Shando Robo Saya. Indandoske Telebe. Ribanduska Tayanda. I hear the Lord says
by your power
that irrespective of what has happened in the past, he said your tomorrow will be greater than your yesterday. And even those that looked down at you and say you will not rise again and say nothing will come out of you again. The Lord says that you were broken so that you can be rebuilt. The brokenness was not to kill you. The marriage could have caused you to lose your mind. The troubles you went through could have caused you to lose your mind. The accident could have killed you, but the Lord says, I've kept you. And the Lord says, I've kept you for this time. I hear you crying out to God. And I hear you saying, nobody understands what I'm going through. Nobody understands what I'm experiencing. And I hear you saying, I'm tired. The Lord says, don't get tired. Don't get weary. The Lord says, your season of reaping, your season of reaping, it's here. It is here. I'm going to do one more prayer. I'm just going to do one more call. There's about six of you in here. Your mind is on overload. There's six of you in here. Your mind is on overload. There's six of you. Six of you. I'm saying six persons. Your mind is on overload.
Yes. Amen.
Come quickly. Your mind is on overload. Come, elder. As you come, if you're part of the six, as you come, just lift your hand. Keep your right hand up. Touch your tummy. It's an overload. Overload, overdrive. Cannot take anymore. One, two, three, go,
touch,
go,
touch by your power,
go,
touch by your
spirit, go now, pass and come out. Who's that woman you're being tormented in the night? You're being tormented. You actually cannot sleep. You're not up front here. You're seated. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. Lift your hand. Those of you that came. Besides your mom, there is still someone else. There is still someone else. Seated. Come on, come on. Father, the overload.
Yes.
The overload.
Break.
The overload.
No more.
Touch now.
Yes, Lord.
Touch now.
Touch, Father.
Loose
in the
and
name
go.
Of Jesus.
Karabash,
in the name
kataraba.
Of Jesus. By fire.
Down.
By fire.
And come out.
By fire.
Now. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go.
By fire.
Now.
By fire.
Go.
Holy Ghost fire.
Go. Now.
Holy Ghost fire.
Go. Go. The overload. The overdrive.
Every burden be lifted up.
Go.
Every weight be lifted up. In the name
now,
of
go.
Jesus.
Overload. In the mind.
Yes, Lord.
Go. Go now.
Go.
Come on.
Drop
now.
Drop now.
Loose her head and
drop,
go.
Drop, 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 drop.
Kaliba shikata.
For those online, God.
Reka
all those whose mind are on overload.
Go, go, go.
I release a word.
Now.
A word to find them where they are, God. In their homes, wherever they are at this time. Let that anointing touch them. In Omoski. Randoro konda ramanda. Let, oh God, your hand touch your people. Break, 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 break. Break, break, break. Yetoshi tarabateke. Ratondo manda. Mosi kotoromosi andaraba. Break. Lift every burden, Father. Every burden. Let it be lifted up. The minds of your people. The hearts of your people. The shoulders of your people. You are the way maker. Namasotu. Rata sheketo kumbana manayanda. Ah, God, show up, Lord, in your glory. Show up in your strength. Show up in your power. Right here at this altar. Right here, God, in their homes. Wherever they are, show up, Father. Let every chain be broken. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, they are on overload. Breathe now. Release your wind of refreshing upon them wherever they are right now, God. Lift every burden because you are the burden bearer. Make a way where there seemeth to be no way, O God. Our God, lift, 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 lift the burden, O God. You said you are not giving us more than we are able to bear. My God, some of the weights heavy, Oshitoro Bondi, Repete Katan Kontongo, Rondo Noramoni and Rabadandi, Anamaga, Yekotakashikonomo, visitation, fresh visitation happening right here at this altar, fresh visitation happening right here at the altar, fresh visitation happening right there at the altar. Eko na mando korobo sheterebe ratata yeku na mama mama mama. Fresh visitation happening right there at the altar. Kari andera bandera bandi masheke terebeski rabatata yandera bahandai. A fresh visitation, God, happening right there at the altar. Kari andera bandera bandi roko soto robo shianda. Father, you are healing your people. You are lifting the burdens of your people. Masse terebe, romongondangandashi kanamande, ena masaya. Father, touch. Touch, Lord. Touch, touch, touch. The weights, let it be lifted up, O God. Ena moso toroboshe nemeyandaba. This is a time of refreshing. A season, O God, where you are lifting the burden. By your power, for by the anointing, Jesus breaks the yoke. Lord, let every yoke be broken in this place here today. Karokushe terebe, rende mangundo, meshia tarabanda. Lord, in house and online today, let there be a breaking, God, a breaking, a deliverance coming to your people right now, in the name of Jesus. By the power of the anointing, let resurrection power move in this place today. Rokoto shitarabandi, anamasi andarabahandai. Oh God, oh shatarabanduro boko shetrebe rekata tatata yakata manda randarabanderebendo kundarabanderebande. Do it, O God, by your power. Let everything that is not of you be shifted today. Ekeramato maramama. This is a day of divine encounter. Father, this is a day where you are doing it by your spirit, where you are doing it by your power. This is a day, God, where you are touching, where you are breaking every weight be lifted up. The wind of God blow now. Wind of refreshing be released in this place right now. The wind that has your presence, let it blow, God, right now. Now, right now. And let everything, oh God, that your people are carrying be broken. You're doing it now, Lord, by the power of the anointing. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Glory be to God. Hey, hallelujah. Touch.
There's a woman who keep on talking about marriage. You're not married. And you're not in a relationship. But you keep on talking about marriage. And you've given yourself 2 years. Within the next 2 years, you say you're going to get married. One. And then you said if it doesn't happen within 2 years, you forget about marriage. I speak about one particular person. If this is you, come. If this is you, come. I know you're here. I'm not asking. I know you're here. You gave yourself 2 years to get married. If it doesn't happen within 2 years, you said you're not going to do it. But your time is not God's timing.
Man, come on.
Your time is not God's timing. Because I hear God says, I'm choosing for you. Because you have been making your own decisions, your own choices.
Big Lord. Hallelujah.
And God says, I'm choosing for you.
Yes.
The Lord says, I've never gone wrong in my choosing.
Amen.
And so the Lord says, I'm choosing for you this time.
Speak, Lord.
This time.
Speak, Lord.
Ah. You're at a place where you're almost angry at men.
Go ahead.
Because they have disappointed you time and time and time, yeah, and time again.
Ooh.
There is still someone else. There's still someone else seated.
Amen.
There's still someone else in this house.
Amen.
There's still someone else. Come. You know you. I don't know how to call you. You know
Amen.
You. Because you've been disappointed time and time and time,
yes,
and time and time and time,
oh,
and
yeah,
time and time again.
Yes.
You've been disappointed. My God, but God says, I'm making it plain. I'm
yes.
doing it for you.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Listen,
Jesus.
This is not about people.
No.
This is about you and God.
Amen. Come on.
Because there's some things that is working in your generation.
Hallelujah.
Come that on. Will cause you to choose what is not lawful for you. Listen, there's someone you're still seated. You
Amen.
Need to stand up.
Yes.
I am not asking you. I am telling you.
Yes.
Hey. I'm telling you.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you. If you want this marriage, if you want the God-appointed man, you better listen to this word here
Amen.
Today.
I can literally go and take somebody by the hand, but you are clear, so I will not.
Because watch, you've cried over the choices that you've made. You've hurt over the truth. I know we want to go, and it's okay. If you want to go, it's okay if you want to go home. If you want to go home, but there's someone that needs this.
Yes. Hey.
Because your choices of men have not been the right one.
Go ahead.
They start off good, but they always end up the same way.
Amen.
Same way, same pattern. Nothing different. Same way, same pattern. And you can identify with that.
Yes.
Are you smiling? That's true, right? It's falling your plate.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, I was hoping it would fall on your plate.
Come on, Jesus.
There's one more person. There's one more. Yes. Listen, God will speak to you.
He don't make mistakes.
I hear you crying, daughter. I see you crying. I see your tears trickling. And folks don't know how much you're hurting. And most of your behavior is as a result.
Amen. Amen.
Of your pain.
Amen. Father, touch.
Sometimes you feel like you can just go and just make a decision and you just don't care who say what or what they think. Oh God. There will be wedding bells ringing. There will be wedding bells ringing in this house.
Amen.
Mark my word. Today is what, the 15th? Within the next 2 years, we may have at least 4 to 5 marriages in this house. Some of you, it may happen sooner than you think. Some of you may meet that man. And let me explain this to you. Because when it's a God-appointed man, you'll meet him. And then within the 6-month period, you're going to get married.
Go ahead.
Because he will have no time to waste. As a matter of fact, within 2 months, he is going to tell you, I want to marry you.
Speak, Lord.
I'ma lift your hand up. Lift your hand up. I'ma lift your hand up. Because you have been crying. Lift your hand up. Yes, lift your hand up. See, people can look at you and don't know that there is pain behind a smile. Father, touch. Touch. Touch God. Now, it's one thing to see people get married and another thing to imagine you walking down the aisle.
Those that are viewing online today, God, and those in house, let that the power of that word encourage them, Father. Let it cancel out every word of negativity that may have been spoken to your people here today. Oh, Karabashi, for you have the last say, Father. concerning your people. Whose report shall they believe? Mighty God, I declare that they shall believe the report of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the month of divine encounters. Thank you, Lord, for your hand. Thank you, Lord, for what you do. Every monitoring spirit, every foul spirit, oh God, that has the people in bondage or in captivity, let it be broken. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Touch, Lord. Touch your people, Father. Touch them now. By your power and by your word. Touch. Father, all those that believe. Hallelujah. If anybody did come with a seed and you want to plant that seed, you can come now as we are getting ready to close. Hallelujah. As long as the earth remain, seed time and harvest time shall always remain. So if you came with a seed, whatever it is that you're believing God for, give your seed a name and you can come to the basket. Hallelujah to Jesus. But if you don't have a seed, shall we all stand? Hallelujah. Be not distracted, people, please. Somebody's getting the deliverance. Again, if you came with a seed, then you can come and bring your seed before the Lord. And give your seed a name, that when that seed begins to germinate and work for you, you will know that it was the Lord. Hallelujah to Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, God, for the seed. I thank you, God, even as your people have planted it, Lord, I declare that the soil is a fertile soil. And mighty God, I pray, God, that whatever it is that they are believing you for, it shall come to pass. Let the devourer be rebuked, oh God, for the sake of your people today. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Hallelujah. Shall we all stand to be dismissed? Shall we all stand to be dismissed? Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, the power of the anointing. Father God, I thank you for what have been done in this place today. I thank you, God, for the divine encounters, Lord, that have happened in the lives of your people, those in-house, as well as those that are viewing there today. Mighty God, I thank you because it is an encounter that will cause change to come on the inside of your people. Mighty God, today, even as they leave this place, but not your presence, I pray, God, that you will continue to allow them to be filled with the power of your Spirit. Father, guide, protect them, Lord. Keep them in all of their ways. I rebuke the devourer over their finances. I rebuke, God, every spirit of accident and mishap. And Father God, for those who were delivered healthy, Father, I pray that you will give them the unction, the strength, the fortitude, that they will continue to walk in that deliverance. And mighty God, I simply say thank you for the word, the power of the word, God, of divine encounters today. So Father, as I thank you for your people, as I release them into your hand, I say, have your way in their lives, in Jesus' mighty name. And the people of God say, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.